Let's have a look at the difference between an analog and a digital signal in this video. If you look at this graph here of potential difference against time, you can tell straight away that it is an analog signal because the potential difference of voltage can take any value and is continuously varying. But for a digital signal, it can only be one of two values. It can either be one or zero, or you can think of it as being on or off. So this graph here shows pulses of signals. Analog data such as sound can be stored on vinyl records. And on the surface of a vinyl record, there are small grooves. The depth and length of these grooves will determine what the analog signals are. As for digital signals, like those stored on a CD or DVD, we say that there are pits or gaps that represent the two values of digital signals. There are plenty of advantages for storing information in a digital format, and that's why nowadays we tend to store information digitally. You can store a large quantity of digital data in a small area, and they're easy to recover if they ever get damaged. Take this digital signal, for example. You can see that it's become quite noisy, but I can recover it easily because I can tell exactly which section is one and which section is zero. So I can clean up the noise to restore a perfect digital signal.